ब्रह्मानाथ। शांति शांति शांति। स्वस्थ।
Hello students, in the previous class we discussed about the active immunity and the passive immunity. We discussed that the acquired immunity, it is divided into two types. One is your active immunity, other one is your passive immunity. In the active immunity we discussed that it is the immunity which is developed by our own immune system. Okay, it can be due to, means it can be natural or it can be artificial. Okay, natural means such as we can say if smallpox is being happened to us or disease happened to a person. So if another time that disease occurs, then it have, we can say it have the antibody against them to fight. Okay, means it is a natural, when the pathogen enter into our body, it creates antibody against them. And also we discuss the artificial, means the antibody are formed, but it is induced by the vaccine. When vaccines are introduced in our body, then antibodies are formed. Okay, so these are your active immunity. Passive immunity means immunity is received by a person in a ready-made form. That also we discussed in the natural way and in the artificial way. Further, we discussed the lymphoid organs where the maturation of the lymphocytes takes place. Then we discuss the allergy, then the allergen is the agent of the allergy. Next we discuss the autoimmune disease, and lastly we discuss the immune deficiency disorder, which is also two types. One is a primary immune deficiency disorder and the secondary immune deficiency disorder. Today we'll discuss our new topic, that is our vaccination and immunization. So what is the term vaccine? We can say vaccine is defined, simply we can say vaccine is defined as a preparation of bacteria, virus and some other pathogenic agents. Why we call it agents? Because it causes the disease. Okay, so the vaccine is defined as the preparation of bacteria, viruses and other pathogenic agents. Okay, and they are administered to an organism, okay, for developing their protective immunity. Vaccine can be defined as preparation of bacteria, bacteria, viruses and other pathogenic agents, means will cause the disease, pathogenic agents, and they are administered means applied into an organism with an objective of developing their protective immune system. Okay, so simply what is the vaccine is, means it can be defined as preparation of bacteria, viruses and other pathogenic agents. Okay, means taking, or we can say it is their life form, their weak form, their attenuated form, or some portions, or we can say, okay, some polysaccharide forms. Means they are next, they are applied into an organism, means they're intentionally applied into an organism so that their immunity will develop or their antibody will develop against that particular disease. Okay, you should always remember that vaccine is not that it is a, we can say it is a medicine. Vaccine in general way, we can say it is a, we can say it is a part of our preparation of some, we can say the other bacteria, virus and some pathogenic agents, some portion or we can say minor form of the pathogens. Means maybe we can say it's life form, it's attenuated or weak form. Means one particular agent or pathogen is causing a disease. Then we are manually or we can say we intentionally taking some fraction or minute form of that pathogen and we are introducing that into an organism. Okay, means as we are taking, means while taking, we'll take some minute form or we can say the weak form, okay, some polysaccharides or etc. When that will introduce into the body, it will not cause any disease, but it will, the body's immunity system against that particular pathogen will develop and antibody will also develop for that against that particular pathogen. So vaccines are taken in advance, polio vaccines are taken in advance, hepatitis B vaccines are taken in advance so that if that particular antigen enters into our body, then it could not create any harm to our body because the antibody is already made in our body against the particular pathogen. You understood? So next, what are the various types of vaccines? There are total 10 types of vaccines. First is your natural live vaccines. We'll read in detail. Live attenuated vaccine means weak vaccine. Inactivated vaccine so that no disease can be caused. Toxoids, combination vaccines, polysaccharide vaccines. Okay, cell means over the cell where the layer is the capsule like substance is called the capsule or the polysaccharide vaccine. Cellular fraction vaccine, then the DNA vaccine, the recombinant antigen vaccine, and lastly the live vector vaccine. So in detail, we'll discuss all the vaccines. So your doubt is clear, means we have always we have a doubt that vaccine means it is a medicine. No, you always remember that vaccine is not a medicine. It is just a part of, or we can say minor form of the disease causing pathogen which causes a disease in our body. Okay, we taking that pathogen only which cause disease in our body, but we are taking a minute form of the pathogen, means some fraction of the pathogen, so that when it will enter into our body, our immunity will develop, our antibody will develop to that particular pathogen. But that pathogen, when we are intentionally introduced as a vaccine, that will not create any disease in our body. Remember that. That will not create any disease in our body. But when that minute form of pathogen will enter into our body, obviously our body will distinguish it as a non-self. Okay, means it is not our own cell. Means against when our own body immune system will will identify it is a non-self, then what it will do? It will act as a foreign particle, means the antigen will act as a foreign particle, and against that foreign particle or pathogen, antibody will produce in our body. Then due to the memory cells, it will be stored. And next time when that antigen will enter into our body, as the memory cell is reminds that particular antigen, it quickly shows response and it quickly produce antibody and fight against that antigen. You understood the concept of the vaccination? Okay. So what is vaccination means? Up to when the preparation of the, we can say, minute form of the pathogen is prepared and that is introduced in our body, up to that is your vaccination. Then when the pathogen enters, the minute form of the vaccine, or we can say the pathogen or the vaccine enter into our body, and against that when antibody develop, when immune system is developed, then that portion is nothing but your immunization. means your immunity system is being activated and antibodies are being developed against that particular pathogen. That is immunization. Up to vaccines are introduced, preparation of vaccine and introducing the vaccine into our body, that is vaccination. After that, immune system activated, antibody form against a particular pathogen, that is immunization. Okay. And lastly, we'll discuss the 10 types of the, or just we have discussed the types of vaccine, which we will discuss in detail. So these are the types of vaccine: natural live vaccine, live attenuated vaccine, inactivated vaccine, toxoids, combination vaccine, polysaccharide vaccine, cellular fraction vaccine, DNA vaccine, recombinant antigen vaccine, and the live vector vaccine. Okay, please note down. Next, we'll discuss two types of vaccine. What is your natural live vaccines, which includes the non-pathogenic agents, and the live attenuated vaccine. So first, this vaccine includes the natural non-pathogenic organisms, okay, and also it includes such as your cowpox virus vaccine, then your, we can say, the simian and bovine retroviruses vaccines, which are used in the vaccination. But this vaccine is not up to mark use, means this have a moderate success. This does not have much success in the field of the vaccination, so it is currently not used. Next is your live attenuated vaccines, means live, what are the live form, what are the kill form, we'll discuss later. Live attenuated vaccines means attenuated, means weakening form of the vaccine, so that it can be, it will be able, means the means it will not cause any disease. So we can say attenuated means weakening, and as the weakening form of the pathogenic agents we are taking, then it is less virulent, means it is not much harmful. Obviously, it will not cause any form of disease inside our body when it is entered into our body, but the antibody will form against the particular antigen. So the weakening of the pathogenic bacterium or virus, making it less virulent, means less harmful, so they do not cause disease. Okay, and some of the live attenuated vaccines are BCG for the TB, BCG for the TB or the tuberculosis. Okay, next, vaccines are for such as polio, yellow fever, measles, etc. Okay, so these are your two types of vaccines. One is your natural, we can say, the live vaccine, and another one is a live attenuated vaccine. In the natural live vaccine, we discussed that it is the includes the non-pathogenic organisms. Next, the cowpox virus vaccine, the simian and the bovine retroviruses are used in the vaccination, but it is have a moderate success, so it is not currently used. But in the live attenuated, means the weakening form of the pathogens are being taken, by which it is less virulent and it does not cause any disease. Examples are BCG for the tuberculosis, and also various vaccines for polio, yellow fever, measles, etc. Okay, this is your natural live vaccine, this is your live attenuated vaccine. Please note down. Next, we'll discuss two more vaccine. One is your inactivated vaccine, and the next one is your toxoids. Inactivated vaccine means it is inactivated completely the pathogen, and in toxoids means it, the pathogen secretes various toxic materials. Okay, next, inactivated vaccine, what happens? It is the inactivation of the whole pathogen or the antigen. Okay, obviously, when the antigen in being introduced into our body, obviously against that the antibody will develop, but it is applied into the, or it is administered into an organism in the form of a, we can say, the inactivated form, so that it cannot cause any disease. But it will help in developing the antibody. Next, how it is inactivated? It is inactivated by using the formaldehyde treatment or simply the heat treatment. By applying the formaldehyde, or we can say applying the heat, this type of treatment is done by making them inactivated. And some examples are the Salk polio vaccine and the whooping cough. Okay, Salk polio vaccine, whooping cough. Next, what is toxoid? As I said, certain organisms, or we can say pathogens, secretes or produce toxins such as diphtheria, tetanus, bacteria. Okay, what in this case, what is done? The toxin which is secreted from the pathogen, it is first detoxicated or detoxified, means the toxic substance is being derived out from the toxic material, and then it is used as a or we can say used in the vaccine, and that vaccine is introduced into a particular organism. Okay, so simple forms, these terms are there. First we discuss the natural life, then we discuss the live attenuated. Natural live vaccine means what? The live form is being taken or introduced into the other organism. Live form of the pathogen is being introduced into the other organism. Live attenuated means live form of the pathogen is being introduced into the body, but it is weakened, means it has become less violent. And now we discuss the inactivated and toxoids. Inactivated means what? It is inactivated by the using the formaldehyde treatment and the heat treatment. And toxoid means the toxins is been derived which secrete, or the pathogen will secrete toxin, and that toxin is being detoxified, then it is introduced. If we introduce that toxic substance to the body, it may cause various diseases, or we can say it may cause various complications. But if the toxic is being detoxified and then it is introduced, it is used in the vaccine, and that is used in the organism, then it will cause less harm, or we can say it is less harm, not it is does not cause any harm, but it will form the antibody against that particular pathogen. So these are simple. Okay, just remember the heading, you can write accordingly. Okay, according to the name only all the descriptions are there. Okay, so next is your toxoids. Also, it provides the passive immunity for short period. Okay, it is helpful for giving the passive immunity for the short period. Passive immunity means what? It gives immediate, quick response. Okay. Next, examples are your diphtheria, tetanus, etc. Okay. So, in inactivated vaccine, the inactivated form of the pathogens are being introduced into the other organisms. Okay, and it is inactivated by the help of the formaldehyde and the treatment or the heat treatment. Okay, examples, Salk polio vaccine, whooping cough, and the toxoids, certain organisms which produce toxins, those pathogens are taken, or those toxins are taken, and that is detoxified, and that is used in the vaccine, and that is introduced into the body. Okay, and your common examples are the diphtheria and tetanus, and it is also provides the passive immunity for a short period. Okay, please note down. Next, we'll discuss two more vaccination. That is, one is your cellular fraction vaccine, and other one is your combination vaccine. Okay, cellular fraction vaccine or the combination vaccine. Cellular fraction vaccine, in which the vaccines are being prepared from the or extracted from the cellular fraction, or simply we can say from the cell wall. Means when from the organism's cell wall, the pathogen, we can say the vaccines are being taken, and it is introduced or used as a vaccine, and then it is administered or applied into an organism, then that is called a cellular fraction vaccine. Okay, just you remember these terms and you can write it accordingly. It is as simple as it is. Okay, means the extracted form of the cellular, the fractions are being used in these vaccines, and in this the efficiency and the safety is appeared to be much high. Okay, and the example is your meningococcal vaccine. Next, in the case of the combination vaccine, what the name suggests, combination vaccine means combined form of the vaccine, means from, or we can say, three different type of pathogen or pathogenic agents are being combined, and it is used as a vaccine, and then it is introduced into the organisms, so as to it will develop immunity in combinedly for that particular, or we can say for that combined disease. Means for common example, if various antigens, means the antigens or some portion of the antigens are being taken for particular disease, then it will create the antibody in combined form for that 3 or 4 diseases, or we can say more than one diseases. So it is known as the combined form. See what happens? More than one kind of immunizing agent is included in the vaccine. Okay, means in general case, we were supposed to take only one particular type of pathogen which will introduce in our body, and it will create antibody for that particular disease. But in this case, what happens? Means we can say combination of diseases, for some combination of diseases, we are taking a combination of vaccines by which it will form a particular antibody which will fight against all those particular pathogens. Okay, so in this, the more than one type of, we can say, immunizing agent is being included in the vaccine. Example, DPT. diphtheria, pertussis and the tetanus. Okay, in this one vaccine, it will fight against the three diseases such as diphtheria, pertussis and the tetanus. Simply DT, it will act for the diphtheria and plus tetanus. MMR for measles, mumps, rubella, this vaccine will act for these three. And this vaccine will fight for these two diseases if it in the future it comes into our body. Okay, so it is simple as it is. Cellular fraction means the vaccines are prepared from the extracted cellular fraction. Okay, and its efficiency is safety is appeared to be very high, much high, and the example is meningococcal vaccine. Whereas in the case of the combination vaccine, means more than one kind of immunizing agent is being included in the vaccine. And the examples are DPT, diphtheria, pertussis and tetanus. DT means diphtheria plus tetanus. MMR means measles, the mumps and the rubella. Okay, please note down. Next we'll discuss two more type of vaccine. One is your polysaccharide vaccine and next one is your live vector vaccine. Okay, in the polysaccharide vaccine we can say simply the cell, obviously the cell have the covering, a capsular like covering called the polysaccharide covering. So that polysaccharide is used as an excellent form of the vaccine. Okay, that polysaccharide is being extracted from the particular organism or the pathogen, and that is being used as a vaccine, which is the in other way we can say also it is the excellent form of the vaccine. And some common examples are your Haemophilus influenza, Streptococcus pneumonia. Okay, next, the live vector vaccines. In this, the desired code, okay, the desired gene coding for the target antigen means the particular desired, we can say, the gene, okay, which is a use for the target antigen is being extracted, okay, and that is being joined with the particular vector. Maybe it may be the attenuated bacteria or virus. Okay, so next, what happens? The desired gene is being extracted and it is being, we can say, joined with the vector, which is the attenuated, we can say, the bacteria or the virus, means we can form of the bacteria or the virus. Then that when we join the particular target gene having the, we can say, for the target antigen is being joined with the vector, which is the inactive which is the attenuated form or weakened form of the bacteria and the virus, then it is being inoculated into the organism where it replicates and serves as the source of antigen. Okay, the replication part, or we can say the introducing or the joining part, this will you will know in detail about later, but as of now you just remember this, that a particular gene, okay, which is used for the target antigen is being extracted. Okay, means it is from the other pathogen, it is being extracted. Then it is being introduced, or we can say used in the vector, or we can say the live form of the weakened form of the bacteria and the virus. Then that portion is being inoculated or introduced into an organism where it replicates and acts as the source of the antigen. And against that antigen, the antibody, or we can say the immunity system is being developed. And the antibodies are also developed. And the common examples for it are your BCG strain, okay, of Myobacterium, then the Vibrio cholera, smallpox, adenovirus, etc. Okay, so now we discuss two vaccines. One is a polysaccharide vaccine in which the capsular polysaccharide of bacteria is extracted and it is used as an excellent form of the vaccine. Example are Haemophilus influenza and the Streptococcus pneumonia. Next, the live vector vaccine in the which the desired gene coding for the target antigens are being taken and it is used or joined in the vectors, which is the attenuated form of the bacteria or virus. Then it is being inoculated into the organism and where the replication takes place and it acts as the source of the antigen. And common examples are your, we can say, the BCG strain of Myobacterium, Vibrio cholera, smallpox, adenovirus. Okay, please note down. Next we'll discuss two more vaccine. One is your recombinant antigen vaccine and other one is your DNA vaccine. In the recombinant antigen vaccine, the recombinant DNA technology is being used, in which we'll read in detail in our further classes, in which the desired DNA is being taken, it is introduced into the plasmid, then the replication occurs. In detail, we'll read about the recombinant DNA technology. Here what happens? Desired DNA in which coding is present for a particular protein. So that particular DNA will help, or we can say it is extracted, okay, from the organism in which a particular protein is being produced, by which a particular protein is being produced, and that is being introduced into a particular organism, by which it will produce that particular protein which will act as the antigen. And from that antigen, the immune system will develop and antibodies will form. So in this, a gene coding antigen protein can be introduced, which is expressed in yeast, bacteria, or even various mammalian cells using, I told already, the DNA, recombinant DNA technology. And after that, the cell culture happens, by which the proteins are being produced. Okay, as the protein produced act as the, we can say, the antigens. So it is also, we can say, the express surface antigen, and this antigen will help in producing the antibody, or we can say it helps in developing the immunity system. Next is your DNA vaccine. Okay, what happens in the DNA vaccines? The suppose this is a bacteria, okay, and this one is your, we can say, the DNA. Apart this DNA, another extracellular DNA is present, which is known as your plasmid. This plasmid is, we can say, is we are taking in this case. Okay, in which, okay, so in this case, what happens? The deliberate introduction of the DNA plasmid, okay, DNA plasmid and the DNA are two different things. Okay, as I said, one DNA is present and another extracellular DNA, that is called your plasmid, is present. So we are discussing here about the DNA plasmid, or the plasmid DNA. Here the introduction of DNA plasmid is done into the muscle cells of the recipient. Okay, to the recipient muscle cells, the plasmid DNA is being introduced. After that, the plasmid contains a protein coding gene. That particular plasmid contains a protein coding genes which helps in producing a particular protein. Okay, next, that particular protein which act as an antigen. Okay, and sorry, will act as the antigen. And this antigen expresses, or we can say, means as this antigen will help in developing our immunity, such as your AMI, antibody mediated immunity, and the cellular or the cell mediated immunity. Okay, means in this, the plasmid DNA is being firstly extracted from the various pathogen. Okay, simple, see, for plasmid DNA is being extracted. Okay, plasmid DNA and that DNA is two different things. Plasmid DNA is being extracted, in which the protein coding gene is present, which will help in developing a particular protein which will act as an antigen. Then that particular plasmid DNA will be introduced in the muscle cells of the recipient, where that DNA, plasmid DNA, will helps in protein producing the particular protein, as the gene coding, the DNA coding for the protein is being present. When the proteins are being produced, it act as the antigen, and when that antigen is being produced, it will help in developing the immune system. Okay, and for that immune system, we develop the antibody. Okay, and it is expressed in the case of the, we can say, the AMI, antibody mediated immunity, and the cell mediated immunity. Okay, so this is all about your recombinant antigen vaccine, and this one is your DNA vaccine. Okay, please note down. So lastly, we'll discuss after the vaccination, that is the immunization. As I said earlier, vaccination means what? The preparation of the, we can say, the agent, or the agent such as your, the pathogenic agent such as bacteria, virus, okay, and that is introduced into the body or the organism. So that is about your vaccination. When the vaccination is being introduced and the immunity system is being activated and it develops antibody, then that is known as your immunization. Okay, the complete process is not vaccination. Up to the introduction of vaccine, that is vaccination. After that, when antigen against the antigen antibody will form, immune system will develop, or we can say activated, then that is known as your immunization. So this simple one, immunization is the process in which the body produces antibody, as I said, produces antibody against the vaccine. Okay, when the vaccine is being introduced, as the vaccine consists of, as we discussed, so many live form, or we can say attenuated form. Okay, the polysaccharide vaccines, okay, due to this particular vaccines, the antibody is being produced, as it will act as a foreign particle, and that against the foreign particle, the various antibody will form. And obviously, this will prevent from the disease through the, we can say, the administration means application of the specific vaccine. Means when the particular vaccines are being applied into the organism, they will develop as a foreign, they will act as a foreign particle. And when they will act as a foreign particle, against them, antibody will develop and it will prevent from the specific disease. Okay, next, means specific disease means the antibody are formed, means when, or and also by the help of the memory cells, when that particular antigen will re-enter into our body, then what happens at that time, it will show quick response and will form antibody against them and fight against the particular antigen. Okay, and lastly, the vaccination provide immunization after some time period, or we can say when vaccines is being introduced in our body, it will obviously the first time as well, it will produce the antibody, so it will take some time. But after that, the due to the memory cell, it will remind that particular antigen, and whenever a particular that particular antigen will re-enter into our body, then it will not take much time to produce the antibody. It remembers that particular antigen, it will quickly show the response against that particular pathogen and fight against them and kill them. Okay, so that any harm could not happen to our body. As the immunity system is being developed and the antibody is being produced to against that particular pathogen. Okay, so today we discussed the what is vaccine. As we discuss vaccines, or we can say the preparation of the bacteria, viruses and some pathogenic, and it is administered into the organism's body, okay, by which the immune system or immunity system is being developed or activated. Then we discuss various numerous type of the vaccines, such as your natural live vaccines, live attenuated vaccines, polysaccharide vaccines, DNA vaccines, recombinant vaccines. Okay. Next, lastly, we discussed recombinant vaccine in which the recombinant DNA technology is being used. Lastly, we discussed the immunization in which the process. When the vaccine enters into our body and the antibody is produced against that particular pathogen, means when the next time if the antigen will re-enter into our body immune system will quickly develop and it will show quick response against that particular pathogen and fight against that particular antigen or pathogen. Okay, so that's all for today. We will meet in our next class. Thank you.